Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Heroes of the Storm here on Battlefield of Eternity. To the left, in the blue, we had Complexity Gaming Hoss from the US. We have Blinks as Malfurion and McLentary as Tyrianda. We have Caterpillar as Meridine, Tremulous Jaina, and Hans as Kelta. The old love couple are on the same side. To the right, in the red, we have Cloud9 Maelstrom from the US. And we have K1 Pro as Tazadar, Drunken Train as Ufer, I Dream as Sylvanas, Fan as Kerrigan, and King Kefarin as Yuhanna. So yeah, let's game on. Indeed. And here we see the birdie going across, and I think it's only saw Ufer there. This map is really nice looking, by the way. If you haven't caught up onto that, this is basically the middle ground where it switch out. Here on the left side we do have the angel side, and this is the darker side, Diablo side here. And yeah, it's basically Act 4 in Diablo, I think. I think it's Act 4, right? Yeah. So yeah, we do see, they haven't gotten to lane yet, so here we go. We see 4 people lane so far in the bottom here. Blue haven't decided yet to respawn here, but they are coming down as we speak. And here they come. Oh, Drunk Train, you are going into danger. You are definitely. And that's a lot of damage coming down there on him. And Trummel decides to run through it all and gets a heal here. He's getting a slow as well. And there is a lot of damage now coming on Sylvan because she wanted to get that kill. I don't know if that was worth it though, because she didn't get the kill. So yeah, some people dead already. And there, Judge, oh, 2 for the red side, and Yuhan is taking a lot of damage here as well, actually, and there goes the third kill for, I don't, oh yeah, I'm forgetting that. Oh well, anyhow, 3 kills for the blue side here, Klona, no, that's Complexity, sorry.
Are you ready, heroes?
So yeah, to clarify, Complexity Gaming Hot here on the blue side, and Klona9 Maelstrom on the right side. And yeah, we're getting the Immortal right, spawning in here. There we go. The blues are on the top and the reds are in the bottom. No, and looks like we are going to fight at the red one. Okay. People are getting improved position here. King Catherine wants to come from behind here on Jaina. And he's definitely doing that. But damn, a lot of damage coming down here on Tyrianda. And it was kind of likewise for a minute there for one other play. I think it was Trummel. But yeah, people will be back quickly enough here because of the early game spawn timer. And not much, yeah, most of the damage is happening here. We do see the nice battle, I'm assuming it for you here. And there is over. Red decides to take camp in the meantime here. Blue went back to, where are all the blue people? They are in base. Okay, no DCs, no. These immortals does not do damage by themselves on each other, so they can fight on like this for an eternity. And it looks like no team is actually key on trying to get this so far. Both teams are basically going around trying to see where the other ones are. And the AK1 Pro is, yeah, Meridine wanted to get his ass there. Let's hear, we do see Cloud9 Maelstrom trying to push instead here. In the meantime, there we go, getting some XP from that tower. That's 400 XP in their favor. And then it's nice and easy again. I wonder if both teams have the kind of same strategy that they want to leave the Immortals for a bit. But it feels more like a map control issue for both sides. And yeah. Oh, Trump went basically into Ufer there. Being a bit edgy, trying to talk with his old friend. Well, her old friend, yeah, that's her. And yeah, we do see this lane is kind of nicely pushed. The tower is out of ammunition, and yeah. So it's going to push itself, doing some damage. We might see that XP coming in for him very soon here. It's just a bit of poking once in a while here. On the Immortals have been talked about that they are not super good. Oh, that's a lot of damage on Kerrigan here. Meridian taking a lot of damage as well here, actually, from the camp, actually, looks like. And could be an item as well there. But yeah, as I said, it has been discussed that the Immortals maybe are not super good so far in the game, that some people want them to have a buff because they are quite easily to pick off after you get them, even if you get the full shield. However, that's very depending on if your team is pushing with the Immortal or if it's letting it be alone, and so on, a level disadvantages and all that stuff. So it's still a very open debate, so to say. But yeah, looks. This is like, okay, let's hang in the middle and poke every once in a while on each other. I will get comfy in my chair and watch this all day. But yeah, the red is actually getting good damage here on. Not that good. Well, Kerrigan really wanted to get that damage on Meridian, and there comes the arrow afterwards. Nice follow-up, get that additional stun here. Meridian is getting low. We still see the kind of pressure here from the red side. In the meantime, it looks like K1 Pro is the official poker of the blue Immortal here. They are basically getting them very equal down here. However, the team who kills their Immortal will get the Immortal. That's kind of as well an thing that we talked about, because some people think they're weak. They are thinking about that. It could be because one team is actually not getting an Immortal at all. Nice healing there from Tiranda. Like for instance, on the Golem map, even if you get a zero Golem, you still get a Golem. But here you do not get an Immortal leaf. Oh, that's you're so close to that. Yeah, there she goes. So yeah, you can discuss that for quite some long time here, and it's the red one wins, right? And kaboom, and you're owned. Would be kind of nice if you come down with a sword in him, you're saying. And yeah, if you don't know how this map works, that's the big objective: kill off the enemy's Immortal, and the health that the Immortal had at that time will become a shield that allows it to use range attack for the time it has the shield. So when it doesn't have the blue shield anymore, like now, it becomes a melee character, otherwise it's a range thing. And you see it's going down very nice. They have basically not done any damage so far to the towers, and there we got some damage on it, and it's over. I mean, that's kind of like if you had a zero Golem in Haunted Mines. I might be exaggerating, but I think I'm not doing that much exaggerating. It's an okay point, to be honest, in my opinion. They are. I know that was not a fully charged Immortal. I mean, it had basically no shield at the beginning, but it had full health, and that full health just ran away. So I don't know. For me, it's not the best thing. It's the coolest thing in the world, but it's not the best thing in the world. Someone other totally disagrees with me, of course, and they are free to do so, because it's very much an opinion-based matter so far. I mean, as I said before, if you get a good Immortal, like full shield and full health, if you push with it, it can be good. It can be really good, but I'm comparing it to the kind of Golem situation in Haunted Mines, which is probably not a good comparison in its own of itself, but we will see if they change it or not. However, we have level 10, because I've been rattling about that for fucking ever. Sorry for swearing, but that's true. And so we have the Star 4 here for Tiranda. We have Tranquility for Malfurion. And we do see the Phoenix here for Keltas as usual, Avatar for Meridian as usual, and Water Elemental as usual for Jaina. And we have the Divine Shield for Ufer, which is not unusual. Did I get it right there? I don't think so. And the Archon for Tassadar, and we do have Blessing Shield for Johanna, Whirling Arrow for Sylvanas, and Maelstrom this time for Kerrigan, actually. And we do have the Immortals again. I will say that the Immortals are spawning in quite fast all the time. it's not a lot of downtime on the objectives of the match. It's going all the time. So let's see. It would be fun to see if he could get then 100-100, so to say, on shield and health. Health is always going to be at 100, to be honest, so yeah. But you get my point there. So we could see it if they could make a good push build. I mean, I can imagine that the level would have a great impact as well, depending on what teams are in level when they're trying to fight off the Immortal. But yeah, it's still so early, so you haven't seen, we haven't seen all the possible counters and the things that could happen when Immortal is pushing and he's not pushing and so on. And by the way, if I haven't said it, which I don't think I have, the Immortal will always spawn to the lane that is the least pushed. So he's kind of an equalizer in that sense for the team he's pushing for. I hope I didn't confuse anybody there. If I did, I'm sorry. And yeah, the blue one is full healthy so far. And the red is gone down a bit. As we saw, the last Immortals, they went down very slowly. And yeah, you see, blue side just decided to, F it, we are pushing a bit. I wonder if they wanted that XP for that. Kerrigan taking an arrow to the knee here, and then getting a shield from K1 Pro here. And yeah, they are moving out here. Yeah, I was like, someone is missing, and yeah, Sylvanas was pushing top lane here. So definitely great there, they are one level in the match, and there comes the ulti downs, and that's a lot of damage on the blue side here. And that's, we have seen all the Kerrigan, she's basically just hammering forward here, and there comes some damage. We need an arrow here, he will not go down from that, and well, they should be happy. That's a three people kill here, and are they going to go nuts on that Immortal? Again, could guess Sylvanas going to lane, and yes, she is. Because pushing lane is her thing, but they are actually going back because the lane is kind of nicely pushed already. And you will see now that both these lanes are equally pushed. This one is a bit more pushed because damage to the tower, which this is heaven. So we will see here if he goes to the bottom one here, bottom lane. Oh yeah, it's not done, by the way. Now they need to fight it again. But yeah, blue is already in position though. We do see, by the way, the stacking here. How is that going with Kalle? Well, he has two. Otherwise, I don't think it's a lot of poison here. Or Evevenem. Yeah, screw that word. My mind is not up for it today. Venom, however, is the last word. Avenom. There we go, I think. Or an Venom. Oh, well, let's screw it. Let's skip that. Okay. Well, take some early damage there on Johanna. Red blue team is kind of far back here actually to do a follow up, and Trauma is going all around her. She is spotted, however, on, you can see that by the eye above her name is very. A lot of damage there on Tazra. However, he managed to escape a lot of it thanks to the doubles. That's not the team with the double support, sorry. Yeah, nice standing from Merlin, and the Immortals are done, and you can see that's a good shield right there on the red side Immortal. That's definitely a good amount of shield. So let's see how it pushes now, and it's pushing bot lane actually. So could it be because this is damage? So this little bit is damage? We don't know. But yeah, now because of that shield, he's going to be ranged. We cannot see the damage or abilities he has when he's range heavy. But you see, it was around here, I think, when it begins, so let's hear. The HP is still ticking away. We see Phoenix coming down here. Blue team is. Oh, that's a nice silence there. Oh, that's a nice damage, however, though, from Kaltas on the red team here. And shield is starting to. We have powered down here from the Immortal. At this point, when you have a full team pushing him up, like helping. It's okay, but I mean, it could have been better. They are definitely getting some nice work here, though, however, but if they wouldn't have put with the Immortal, this would not be the same case. And and the Immortal is going down. And they are on the run, actually, here. We do see they pushing here. Both teams are kind of splitting up here, though, however. Trammel is going for Tazra alone down there. And it looks like Kerrigan might help him out. Maybe. They are definitely on the run. Johanna is taking a bit of a different route here. And that's a lot of damage there from Jaina on Tacit Order, and he's down. And ooh, looks like they might get Uther as well here, and they, yep, they got him. But yeah, that was an almost fully charged Immortal for you there. And Yuhanna wants to get the capture there on the camp, but that's not a good time right now. And she's quickly escaping. But they do see that damage can be made, and yep, that's not something you want to encounter right now. He's just trying to be there to see what they are doing. So how is the... Oh yeah, we have a full 4 stack here now. 4 Kel'Thas. And yeah, this is so far looking more to the side of the red because of Taiyuan Forge being down for the blue side here. There we go again. It's not that long time ago since we saw the Immortals, and the counter that you do to like kill them off is quite long as well, so they are tightly spawned together. Wishing more of every Tazar. Blue side is getting the bottom camp here. Looks like they... it's a bit of a decision-making situation here because red is up to push. So they need to pull out of that. Nice ring there from Kel'Thas, dividing them up a bit. Nice route there from Meridian and Malfurion. Here comes the Phoenix down as well, and Kerrigan is doing a lot of that. There comes the silence everywhere. It doesn't take away the Malfurion ulti. And there he icebox himself. He is actually healing while in icebox, don't forget that. But he's taking a lot of damage, but he survives thanks to all the healing. And this actually puts the red team on the back foot right here after a great push, however. But I think a lot of the damage actually was absorbed by Meridian there. And of course, Malfurion healed a lot there. So that definitely say he was almost killed by himself, Malfurion there. So yeah, it was close, it was close. That silence on Sylvana was not badly timed or anything, so that was a good execution there. It just didn't go their way. It was like they needed just that little bit of damage. And we do have level 16 here finally for the blue side, so now we need that ignite, and there we go, it's going to be utilized and doing a lot of damage. Heal all from Uther here on Fan. Uther is still taking a lot of damage, and they are bailing out of there. That was a bit of a hammer throw that didn't hit much. You can see it doing it so much damage just with a hit on Yuhanna here from the Kel'Thas ring. And yeah, there we go. Nice damage from Kerrigan. She gets ulted Yuhanna and survives. And that's, yeah, there we go. Uther is down. He's healing as much as he can here on Yuhanna, but it's not enough. And this is a lot in the favor of the blue team here. Nice. It was a good idea that stun, however, from Tyrande did not hit. And yeah. Tassara, however, is still staying here. And a lot of damage here on the Immortal, so it's going down quickly. And there we go. It's half time, so to say. And there we go. And are they going to try to nuke it down now as well? Or are they going lanes? Well, some damage is definitely coming in here. The red team is responding by coming here as well. They really don't want this kind of big adventure. Phoenix is down on Elephant Kel'Thas. It's on such a short cooldown that you can basically use it when you want, kind of. And now we have the full red team here in the game. And they are actually still ahead in XP and level, so which they kind of need, because that damage is not nice. Some of the blue players are a bit on low on mana here. You see Kel... there Tassar is just hanging at the side there, getting some vision for his team, and they see... Oh, Yuhanna is a bit out of position there, and he actually ulted Tassar right here. And can maybe not get the damage he wants here, but Fan is a bit out of position. It looks like he's having a bit of a panic mode there, not getting to the place where he wants to. And the Phoenix is down once again here, actually, so we did see it just a minute ago. Ulti comes up for Kerr again here. And yeah, this is basically trying to escape here situation, and they are not getting. Oh, yeah, that's a close arrow there, and Ulfur, he's very nicely, and we do see a lot of damage. He needs to start attacking here, Kerrigan, to do that damage, and Sylvanas was very low. Oh, she's so low. And will she survive? A bird could kill her here from Tyrande, but Tyrande is blowing low on running low on mana. And she is running out, and yeah. The blue team is getting back here to the fountain to get their HP up. And some of the red team here are trying to get some damage down to the blue's immortal. And red decides to let's take some camps instead. This is not something we are winning in terms of objective this round. There we go. It's a bit under half shield on the blue side's immortals. And this is, I think, the first blue immortal, right? Might be. Not sure. You got my attention, laddie. And there we go. The immortal is final up. And you see it's ticking away quite heavily. It did get the gate here now. The tower's already down, I think, and here is the thing though. Now we are 20 minutes in, so I would guess that it's doing quite a lot of damage right now, right? That's medic didn't do much, but the auto hit is doing very much damage actually. So early game, the immortals might not be super great, but late game like this, it's looking to be pretty strong in the damage wise, but it's still pretty squishy. The damage might be there, but the squishiness is definitely there as well. It did almost get the tower down. Well, it did, but some follow-up damage happened as well. And yeah, a lot of back and forward, but finally Blue got the equalizer they wanted. But however, this had been pushed far. And towers were actually hitting away at the shield, and it's actually down a couple percent, a couple of, yeah, that's the right word, right? Yeah. But it's down at least, so it doesn't have the 100. And yeah, lots of damage here on Murden actually. He's getting healed up though, however, and there comes the ring doing a lot of damage on Kerrigan, so we do have two ultis, one ulti used here. And it's a quite a long ulti actually here for Kerrigan. It's a 120, right? Yeah, so that's a lot of cooldown. I have to think about those as well, as it's on for a couple of seconds, so it's more like 101.10 cooldown, because it's on for around 10 seconds. Nicely to counter push here, however, though, a lot of red players here are low, and you can see that Tassor is trying to get the Jaina down here. But that Malfurion healing is so strong, if you can utilize it. Oh, there comes the ult super. But looks like Fan is up. Oh yeah, there comes the arrow, and that's a nice placement of abilities there. We did get an arrow, the root, and might be Jaina as well there. And oh, Ulfur goes down as well. This is not good at all here. However, this is a great opportunity for the blue team to finally equalize and get this one. This one should have been killed some minutes ago, I think, because this is far too low to be around. Come on, just send one down. One guy down there and kill it off. And we do see a bird coming to the base. We do are two-man short here for the red side, so this is a bit of a risky, and he get rooted here. And but this is... Oh yeah, great. It's a... What's that called? Dimension something, right? Yeah, dimension shift. From Tassador. They are actually getting a good amount of damage down here. Oh, there comes Hervedo, all the synergy of Root and Arrow and Jaina damage all together rolled up in a little furry ball, killing him off. But yeah, blue team is definitely starting to run low here as well on health and mana. But they are basic at 100 strong here for their own immortal. So yeah, we will see how this ends up. I love this animation. Should have been a bit longer. Probably not for the map, but it would be cool if they could use to a little movie of those two demons fighting. Oh no, we might get one in the future. And yeah, looks like it's basically a race here of some sort who gets the their ones down the most. Reds want to get the blue ones down most because it doesn't get too annoying in lane, and yeah, blue ones response to that is just basically kill off their ones faster or doesn't die, kind of. So yeah, it's a half shield here for the Immortal. We are 24-7 minutes in. Yeah, 24 minutes in. And yeah, so it's going to the bot lane here because that's the one that needs the best pushing so far. And it's a one shot here. You can see now when I have the hit, it's a range. I have no idea if the range is better than the melee, but these guys probably know that better than me. And it's a bit harder to hit definitely for the melee characters if you're having a ranged one, but I mean, so now we see here that there we go, range is over and he's melee and he's doing definitely some good damage here now. And there we get the AoE because people are standing close to him. And we do get Phoenix down as well. They have a really nice little pushing ability-wise situation here for the blue side. And that's the fourth down as well. So this is not looking good so far for the red side here. Taking a lot of damage here. And now it's only core. They really don't want that core to go below. Oh, yeah, they do. And oh, see, another thing, a lot of damage here. Oh, she managed to blink in nicely. Oh, yeah. And now comes the counter push here. And there comes the silence from... Oh, some people are very low here. And yeah, Malfurion is trying to heal the best he can. And he's definitely succeeds. Kerrigan is going down here. And looks like actually Jaina is going down as well. Johanna is low as well. And we do see Phoenix down as well. And Sylvanas is trying to get in. Oh, that's a nice... Oh, nice, nice dodge. And he... And K1 Pro is saying, okay, I can't run there. I'm taking the safer route here. You see that they are low some sense, and yeah, there's only one man down here. They are still a lot of power here to get, and too bad Uther goes down once again. So he's I think his ult is used right. His yeah, that ulti was, yeah, the redemption was already used, and now he actually dies for real here. And nice down there on iDream. Heavy dot, the hunt is definitely on here. Oh, Blinks, that's maybe going to cost you your own life. Storm Shield is coming down here on him. And we do see Kel'Thas trying to do his best he can. He's very dry in mana. And yeah, oh yeah, looks like yeah, Murphy goes down here, but he managed to save Tyrande in the process. So I don't know if that was worth it or not, but not bad at all. And we do see that it's the mortal time again here. And two people are they both will not be down when this starts. It's going to be the one man disadvantage here for the blue side, yes, when the Immortals are on. Heavy Dog, some camps is being captured here. And yeah, it looks like the blue team is doing the same. It's a bit of a downtime here. Both teams are waiting for the Immortals to spawn because both lanes are in this kind of situation where they are pushed to a point when it's kind of dangerous to push them yourself. So you need to kind of stay together at this point, because if someone dies and it's time for a big objective or a big team fight, you could basically lose the game on that. So yeah, oh yeah, Johanna is definitely, yeah, that nice thing. Lucky for you that you have that. Johanna is doing a nice push here though. However, we do see a silence come in here, two people on the blue side. Johanna is taking a lot of damage and she goes down there. And yeah, that could be a nice pickoff that the red side needed. We will see here. K1 Pro is a bit far into the blue side's camp here. The damage is getting done here, however, on the Immortal on blue side here. Both lanes are kind of equally pushed here. We do see some camps pushing each lane here for opposite sides. Of course, nice little dodge there from K1 Pro. You are a bit out of your depth here, however, you are fighting two supports, which yeah, he decides okay, no more playing with that. But it have costing some health and mana, and yeah, let's go the dimension shift. Nicely to save him from that stun. And we do see Phoenix once again down here, but people are running a bit low here for both sides. I would say that definitely that blue side is looking stronger so far in the mana and so on because of the innovation from Malfurion. But look at that damage it took. The ice block is activated, and we do see an arrow that misses. And Fan is actually going 1v1 here with Meridians for some reason. We do see Malfurion's healing is on here, and that's the time to escape. For Red Side, they need to regroup and regain some mana here. I would say that Blue Team's definitely having the longer fights in their hand because of that double support. And yeah, you have to. We do have a double support, of course, for the Red Side as well. Oh, nicely, the lane actually got the other fort here, so we are looking at a stronger fort situation with one fort here for the Red Side. But yeah, that's going to get gathered up there from Keltas. But yeah, as I said, of course, Red is having two supports as well, but you have to think about that. Tassadar is not used as much as the healing support. He has a shield and he doesn't heal as much. So he's more of a offensive support, he's doing some damage and so on. That's usually how people play him. Because you do have Malfurion and Tyrande that are more of those healing support. Malfurion is, of course, healing a bit more than Tyrande, but it's a bit of a difference there between the two teams in the terms of supports versus supports. There we see K1 Pro going ham to ham here, and that's a lot of damage. Didn't get picked up. That's not something you want to see. And I want to point out it's a bugged up here. The portrait for Ufer is great because he died, and I think it's thanks to the redemption he survived thanks to that. Oh, nice. Oh, that's a nice silence there for Sylvanas. However, though, it didn't have a follow up, but it was a nice arrow nonetheless. A bit easier to hit, I guess, when you're someone that four people are hunting someone, but yeah. looks like, yeah, actually Red is in the lead here on HP on their Immortal. I wonder if we are in the second phase yet. I'm not sure. Phoenix is down, however, and Jaina decides to Ice Block there. It looks like the second phase here. They are a bit spread up. You see Johanna there in the top one doing some damage to the Immortal. I wonder if that's intentional to be a more sneaky maneuver. However, she is not doing that much damage. She's coming down here finally because they are starting to lose the... There we go, and ultis are off. Malfurion ulti is off. He's ice blocked himself, so his ulti will be still on, but no one can get to him. And yeah, we really need some damage here. Malfurion's ulti is over, and he's kind of dry on mana. So here comes K1 Pro, and he's running into that ball blazing. He really needs to get some damage down here, and that's a lot of damage. Fan. Oh, he managed to survive that bomb from Keltas with barely zero health here. And Jaina is playing nice with... well, they're basically playing catch here. And Jaina's little water element decides to attack the minions, which was maybe not the best thing here. She would probably gone down either way, because Sylvanas came there to help. And there we go, Sylvanas arrow again, and there it goes. This was definitely a bit of a loss in terms of people going down, but it might have been worth it for the Immortal. However, we will see it now. I think actually Red Team can push this to victory because it's so far into game, the spawn time is not quite high. So even if they do get an Immortal, I don't think it can outpush four people. Because here comes the damage, and it's a lot more, and the Immortal won't manage to get even close to the lane that they need to. And we can just see it ticking over here. The Immortal is over here doing its best, but it's there we see the Gigi from Keltas. He complains, he comes, and it's two arrows there coming down. And yeah, it was definitely a close game. And here comes all the loot. We did get the butchers actually here. And yeah, thank you everyone for watching. Have a wonderful day. Bye bye.